Hi friends, welcome to Technological Trading Lab. Please subscribe the channel to watch best educational and technology videos. I am yours, Shahnawaz. Now let's proceed. Welcome back to the tutorial of Introduction to Computer Graphics. Today we are going to study about the frame buffers. Now we will study about the four different categories of the frame buffer: monochromatic screen for the grayscale screen, and simplest color RGB model frame buffer, and complex color RGB model frame buffer. Today we are going to study about this topic, the theory of the frame buffer. Frame buffer is actually used in the raster scan display devices, that is the modern system are based upon the frame buffer. It is actually a memory which is in the format of the array. In this one, each individual pixel is representing a single bit, and in the single bit we can store either 0 or 1. It may be the part of the main memory, but in the modern system we are using special graphics memory. The frame buffer is actually stored in that graphics memory. Now we are going to start about our monochromatic frame buffer model. Monochromatic stands for the black and white screen. This is your frame buffer. In this one, this frame buffer is just analogous to your computer screen. Suppose that if in your screen you are having 1024 pixel on the horizontal direction and 768 pixel on the vertical direction, the same structure will be available for the frame buffer. And which pixel you want to illuminate on the screen, that is which pixel you want to illuminate white, that pixel will be set to one. That bit will be set to 1, other bit will be set to 0. So because in the raster scan method, the process of scanning is starting from the left to right and bottom top to bottom, so all the bits will be set to 0, and the bit which you want to illuminate on the screen, that is you want to convert in the white format, it will be set to 1. Next we are having register associated with the frame buffer, and in the register we will store one bit at one time, that is one pixel will be processed at one time, and it is connected with the digital to analog controller, which will control the electron gun, that is the movement of the electron gun. An electron gun will emit the light when the bit is set to 1. It will emit the light and that pixel will glow on the screen. The example for the frame buffer, we should know the structure of the frame buffer, how it is stored in the system memory, and how our image is displayed on the screen. Suppose that the example for this one, if we want to illuminate or we want to glow, we want to convert the pixel for this pixel number 100 on the screen to white, and this is for the monochromatic model with the screen resolution 1024 and 768. Then calculate the following: show the frame buffer arrangement of the above system, and the second question is calculate the size of the image for the above system. If user wants to display the single pixel, or if user want to display 100 pixel on the screen, that is the size of the image in this situation for the frame buffer system. Now let us start to solve the problem. What is given to us? The screen resolution is given to us 1024 into 768. This is the screen resolution given to us. That is, the screen is given in this way, 1024 pixel in the horizontal direction and 768 pixel in the vertical direction. The screen is divided into small and very tiny pixels from horizontal to vertical direction. These squares are actually dot in the screen, that is circular format, but here to show mathematically we are using squares. Exactly, they are not the square. This is our screen, and in the monochromatic screen we are having the frame buffer arrangement will be same as the screen because it is analogous. So we are having this one frame buffer. Suppose that this is the frame buffer, so arrangement will be like this one. It is in the format of the memory. So it is one pixel is representing one bit actually. And inside one bit, either you can store 0 or 1. In the single bit, you can store either 0 or 1. Suppose that in our question, it is given that pixel number 100, 100. That is pixel number 100, 100 you want to illuminate on the screen. So pixel number 100, 100, suppose that it is coming at this point 100, 100. So this will be set to 1. Other bits will set to 0. In the frame buffer will set to 0. Other bits will set to 0. And we are having one register, processor register, and it will start. It is connected to the register. It is having DAC, digital to analog controller, to control the movement of the electron gun. And we are having electron gun, and it will start penetrating the screen from left to right and top to bottom sequentially. Okay, so first bit is set to 0. So in the register it will come 0. It will come to this point, and electron gun will not activate actually at this time because the bit is set to 0. So for this position, electron gun will not emit the fire, or it will scan from left to right. And when the pixel number 100, 100 will come, in the frame buffer bit is set to 0, this one will come to the register. Okay, so this one, this pixel number 100, 100 is set to 1. So electron gun will scan the screen. Suppose that it is coming at this position. So at this point, electron gun will emit the light, the electrons will be activated, and this point will be glowing on the screen, will glow on the screen, and it will start scanning the screen from left to right, top to bottom, up to the end. So you will find that the screen, it will start the scanning from left to right and top to bottom. The next question is about the, this is the arrangement for the, our frame buffer with the monochromatic screen. Now we are going to solve the question for the size. Actually, in the frame buffer, the size of the image is equal to the, it is suppose that here we want to glow only a single pixel. For the single pixel or multiple pixel, the size is always same, because it is equal to the size of the complete screen, because the frame buffer is set to 0 for other pixel and set to 1 for the 1 pixel. Either it is 100 pixel, 200 pixel, or all pixel you want to glow on the screen, the size of the image is set to the size of the frame buffer. So the size will be single or multiple pixel if you want to glow. The size is actually same, because the size of the image is same. So the size you can calculate, because it is 1024 pixel on the horizontal direction and 768 pixel on the vertical direction. This will be the size, total number of bits. You can convert them into the kilobyte. That is, this is representing kilo, and 768 divided by 8. So you can convert this to the kilobyte. So it will come approximately 96 kilobyte. So either it is for the single pixel or for the 100 pixel, the size will be same. That is 96 kilobyte for this arrangement. That is 1024 pixel on the vertical direction and 768 pixel on the vertical direction, and 1024 pixel on the horizontal direction.
Now this is the time for your self-evaluation. We will start the assessment. In this one, we are having 6 seconds for the multiple choice question and 4 seconds for the true false. Now let's start. This is the first question on your screen. The answer for this one is black and white images. The second question. The answer is true for this one. The third question. The answer for this one is C, that is screen resolution. Thank you for watching the channel. Please subscribe the channel for more videos.